Reverse PORTS shunt can be considered as a renaissance of the discontinued PORTS shunt for cyanotic congenital heart disease. PORTS shunt was a surgical anastomosis between left pulmonary artery and descending aorta to improve pulmonary blood flow in cyanotic congenital heart disease with decreased pulmonary blood flow. It was a systemic to pulmonary shunt. The report was published 1 year after the Blalock-Taussig shunt, which was also used for a similar purpose. Later, PORTS shunt, like other central aortopulmonary shunts, were discontinued because of higher risk of excessive pulmonary blood flow. A modified Blalock-Taussig shunt is still in use. Reverse PORTS shunt is a pulmonary to systemic shunt for relieving pulmonary arterial hypertension. It is called reverse PORTS shunt because the pressure in the pulmonary circulation is higher than that in systemic circulation. The idea of creating a PORTS shunt in children with severe pulmonary hypertension was based on the information that children with Eisenmenger syndrome had a better life expectancy than severe pulmonary arterial hypertension. An unrestrictive shunt between pulmonary artery and descending aorta reduces the afterload on right ventricle from suprasystemic to systemic levels. This equalization of right and left ventricular systolic pressures produces a physiology similar to that of Eisenmenger syndrome, typically that of patent ductus arteriosus with Eisenmenger syndrome and right-to-left shunt. Compared to an atrial septostomy which produces global hypoxemia, a PORTS shunt will direct highest oxygenated blood to the child's brain. Data from palliative PORTS shunt for the treatment of drug-refractory pulmonary arterial hypertension in the first 24 children was published in 2015. 19 of these patients had conventional surgical PORTS shunt, while the remaining 5 had transcatheter stenting of remnant patent ductus arteriosus. One case had a unidirectional walled PORTS shunt for a child with infrasystemic pulmonary arterial hypertension on intravenous epoprostenol who had repeated centerline infections. Severe postoperative complications occurred in 6 patients in the surgical group, including 3 early deaths related to low cardiac output. For the survivors, over a 2.1-year median follow-up, there was significant clinical improvement in majority of children. It was associated with significant reduction in medications for pulmonary arterial hypertension. Weaning of epoprostenol was obtained in all patients who received triple combination prior to PORTS anastomosis. Retrospective data on 110 children with pulmonary arterial hypertension who underwent a shunt procedure from 13 centers in Europe and United States is now available from the International PORTS Shunt Registry. There were 17 post-procedure in-hospital deaths. 18 of the 93 children successfully discharged home died subsequently or underwent lung transplantation during a mean follow-up of 3.1 years, ranged 25 days to 17 years. 59% of children were weaned completely from prostacyclin infusion after the procedure. Pre-procedural risk factors for in-hospital mortality were admission to intensive care unit, mechanical ventilation, and extracorporeal membrane oxygenation. This would mean that the procedure should be considered before they were severely ill and requiring aggressive intensive care. It was mentioned that 5-year survival was comparable to children undergoing lung transplantation for pulmonary arterial hypertension. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.